everybody, and welcome to RFD TV Live. I'm your host, Lizzie Iwersen. Tonight, my guest is Dr. Harry Anderson, who's the founder and owner of Total Feeds and Total Equine. You've probably heard of Total Equine if you've watched any of our horses on RFD TV lineup. Dr. Anderson, thanks for being our guest tonight.
It's great to be with you, Lizzie. I always enjoy being here.
Well, I want to tell everybody, you know, we're going to be talking about Total Equine. But fear not, if you don't have horses, we want you to stick around because we're going to be talking about all the different feed buckets that Dr. Anderson is filling with his Total Feeds and all the products he has to offer for us folks who have a number of different animals. So, no matter what you've got, stick around. We're going to be answering questions that you have. If anything that you want to know about equine nutrition or nutrition in general, give us a shout at 877-731-6733. Dr. Anderson is happy to answer any questions that you have. So let's get right to it, Dr. Anderson. We've got a lot to cover tonight. I know that we'll probably inevitably run out of time, but let's start with where you got started and a little bit about your background.
Well, my basic background is I was born on a generalized farm, dirt farm and dairy farm in North Dakota during World War II. I entered into business as a young age. I started selling corn seed and raising chickens and peddling them in town when I was about 11 or 12 years old. Before I was allowed to drive on the highway, I was around selling things to people. So I've always done that. But I did attend North Dakota State University, had a degree in animal science, went to South Dakota State University, have a degree in swine nutrition. That was in 1970. Since that time, I have worked for a major feed company. I spent some time at the University of Wyoming as an animal science specialist for the state of Wyoming in dairy, swine, and equine. Then in 1989, I hung out my shingle and became a private consulting nutritionist for mainly feed yards, but then got interested in equine a few years later.
Okay, so you really do know a thing or two about animals beyond horses.
Yes, ma'am. I have worked with almost every species there is.
Okay, so what took you to develop a product for these horses?
I had a request from someone that asked me if I was capable of making a formula that would feed all equine, whether they were large, small, young, old, whether they were donkey, mule, or horse.
Okay.
And at that time, it was very unusual to try that because most products, many, many products for lifestyle, as you well know, even more so today than back then. But I did come up with a formula. I started making it in a pelleted form and was carrying it around in my little 16-foot trailer and peddling it here and there and driving thousands of miles trying to get somebody to buy my feed while I was consulting. And I had some very loyal customers that liked my program. But then one day I was talking to a gentleman that makes extruded feed, and he was convincing me to change my method of processing. So I did, and I came up with the extruded feed that we have today, which looks like dog food or Cocoa Puffs.
Okay.
It's called different names. And as soon as I did that, things started to change, and I started getting referrals, and I had to buy a 20-foot trailer to keep up with my delivery. But I was still peddling it, you know, 20 days out of the month, I was driving up and down the road peddling this feed.
So just you? You were the only
Just me.
Okay.
No one else touched it. And then suddenly it started to skyrocket, and I had to get a 24-foot trailer. And so I hauled that for a while and still delivering feed, and business was growing and growing. But all of a sudden, I couldn't do it anymore. I had to sell my trailer. And now it's all delivered in semis or people pick it up at the plant.
Well, you seem a little sad about that, but this is good news. This is exactly what you wanted to happen.
Yes.
Is for your business to grow. So people you were talking to, and I know you have talked to a lot of people, going out on the road, different disciplines, different breeds of horses, and different folks. So tell us a little bit about that journey and who you first began talking to.
Well, my first people were just friends and acquaintances that I knew, and then I started getting some referrals to some what you would call major names in the industry that people looked up to and watched. They started coming to me using my program. And at that time, then, that's when it really started growing very rapidly, because people would watch them on RFD TV. Mm-hmm. That's the venue I used to get that word out and show the public who was working with me and who supported my feeding program. And that's kind of the end of the story as far as what got it jump-started. It took on a life of its own and has grown ever since. And I really can stop it if I wanted to today.
How many years was it? You know, how long ago did you start with RFD?
6 years ago. I started doing small things on RFD. Nobody knew who I was, but I was giving nutritional tips at that time on all-around performance horse.
Okay.
Then one day I told them where they could find the things I'd been talking about, and that's when the floodgates opened about 4 years ago. They just took off and exploded.
Okay, and here we are now. I mean, I talk to so many people every day in my travels that have switched over to Total Equine and are not looking back.
Right.
People, obviously, we're going to get to know some people today on today's show, find out who's using the feed, what they're seeing, and how and why it's working. So let's get a little bit deeper into what Total Equine is.
Okay.
There are some requirements here.
Right.
When you started, what were those requirements that had to be met with Total Equine?
Oh, yes. The first requirement, as I mentioned, it had to be a formula that would feed all of the equine from baby to the oldest one and all of the performance horses and reproductive, in between. It had to fit all lifestyles and activity levels. So that's the first thing I did. Then I needed to have it provide the safety from colic and founder. I wanted to keep it safe so that if a horse accidentally ate too much, or management-wise somebody fed too much at a time, which can happen on these high grain feeds, I wanted to remove that possibility. And that's why the extruded formula works. The extruded formula has no raw starch in it, period. And if you get no raw starch into the hind gut, you will never colic or founder a horse, because that's what founders should colic some of man-made founder. Now, they can still colic from grass. Mm-hmm. They can have compaction colic, but they're not going to have gas colic from the grain when you feed Total Equine, because there's no way that it can cause that gas.
Well, that's something every horse owner hears and deals with all the time, is founder and colic.
Yeah.
So it's important to understand that our horse's digestive system is sensitive, and we have to be keen to what's going to trigger a problem.
Right.
So what, you know, you mentioned no starch. Tell us a little bit about starch in the hindgut and what it does.
I should have said raw starch, because unprocessed starch is an enemy to the horse. If it gets into the hindgut, it ferments like the grass does, but it ferments very, very quickly.
Okay.
And that's when the excess gas or lactic acid is formed and produced, and that's what causes gas colic and laminitis from the lactic acid. So we remove the raw starch from the program by extruding it.
By extrusion,
And make it soluble so it all digests and absorbed in the small intestine. That's the safety aspect of this program.
Okay, so people can rest assured that if their horses escape and get into the feed room and eat too much, there's no reason to panic.
That's right.
Okay. So it's safe. We like that. Now, one other aspect that people, especially with performance horses, are really high on is the fact that it keeps their horses calm and lowers that energy
level. Yes, calmness comes from not having an upset stomach from raw starch. It also comes from a product I use called ascophyllum nodosum, which helps the nervous system function at its very normal and does not overreact or underreact when a horse faces a situation.
Okay.
One of the reasons horses are nervous, I believe, are that when they get into a normal stimulation, like going in the arena, setting in the box, or getting in the starting gate or whatever it is, they are overreacting because the nervous system is overreacting because of nutrition.
Okay.
If we stabilize that so that it's not going to overreact, all of a sudden they become and act more calm. But at the same time, they have to have the power and strength. And that's the other requirement. They had to have the bulky muscle, I muscle up, and give them more strength, because that's what a horse needs for whatever they're doing. It doesn't matter. They need that bulky muscle.
And it, as far as that being able to see results, when would you see increased muscling?
The muscling increase takes maybe 2 to 4, 5 weeks, depending on the horse. We've seen some within 3 weeks just totally change their muscle structure and their whole appearance. Some take 6 weeks. So it depends on where they start from.
Okay, well, not very long, really, in the whole scheme of things.
No.
And we've all heard the term, no hoof, no horse. So keeping those hooves healthy is, you know,
that's really
critical.
True. And we've had a lot of man-made problems with hooves.
Yeah.
With the starchy feeds and the low level of lactic acid can cause not a severe enough case of laminitis so you would see it, but it restricts that blood flow just a little bit all the time. That hoof does not grow properly. If you pump more blood, and that's what we do with the ascophyllin nodosum, we open up those blood vessels and get more blood into the hoof, and we get the right nutrients into that hoof, they can literally grow a new hoof every 5 months. And customers tell me all the time how that happens in their horses on Total Equine.
Well, I guess it comes down to that opening of the blood, you know, and availability.
It's a very critical thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so another factor that everybody is dealing with and trying to learn more about is how much hay to feed your horse, how important hay is in your whole feeding program. So tell us a little bit about...
Hay is very important, and one of the criteria that I wanted to establish was that I had to improve the fiber digestibility, or the usage of the hay, if you will.
Okay.
So that we can reduce and let a horse get by on less hay than what they used to in nature. And yes, we've accomplished that.
Mm-hmm.
But hay is so, so critical, and the quality of hay.
Right.
And this year, just like the last few years, we've seen some really bad hay show up. And that's why I encourage people to get an assay or a chemical analysis of their hay.
Okay.
I don't care where they buy it. I don't care what they pay for it. An $18 assay is well worth it to save a lot of problems, because almost every time I get a call where a horse isn't performing well, when we get right down to it and I get a hay analysis, the hay is in sorry shape, but they thought it was good. You can't look at hay and mm-hmm. tell what it is. There's no way. I can't. They can't.
Okay.
And how much does a horse need? A horse needs as much hay as they want.
Okay.
So you're not
trying to replace hay?
No.
With your feed?
No. I'm trying to reduce the hay usage by them using more of the hay they take in.
Okay.
Most horses
digesting
on Total Equine will decrease their hay intake by anywhere from 15 to 30%. Sometimes a little more than that, depending on the hay. And that's because they're digesting it that much more efficiently.
Okay. And this is so important to you, getting your hay analyzed, that you can actually visit your website, totalequine.info, click on hay, and directions, you can find out how to send your hay in and get it analyzed, figure out what you're working with, and see if maybe that's the problem.
Right,
if they'll do it
online through that, I will get a copy. And then I can contact them and tell them what I think of it.
Okay. Well, you're just helping people with their horses using both your product and the resources that they have available. So we have a phone call right now.
Okay.
Someone has a question for you, Dr. Anderson. It's Krista from Missouri. Are you there, Krista?
Yes, I am.
All right, perfect. What's your question tonight?
Dr. Anderson, I have friends that basically swear by strategy, safe choice, mixed with sweet feed. They are trying to tell me that the Total Equine is a high-performance feed. I'm wanting to know if a horse that is just a regular trail horse that's not really worked strenuous, if Total Equine is for them, if that can still be beneficial to them.
Yes, very beneficial. As I've stated earlier, this had to be suitable for every horse that walks, whether it's a lawn ornament or the high-performance horse or a baby. And what you'll find in those horses that are not working hard is that it will take fat off the outside, and that's a point that I think needs to be clarified is some people that take a horse that's maybe been on a starchy type diet, then get a little fat on the outside and they get a little pudgy looking. Mm-hmm. Within 2 to 3 weeks of going on total equine, they will almost melt that fat off the outside and they can look a little ragged for a while. But in the process, that horse that's not used much at all will become very athletic looking and will have a bulky muscle. And they will lose that fat, bulk up in their muscle, and they will look athletic whether you're working them hard or not.
Okay, so it doesn't matter what discipline. Like I mentioned before, you have visited farms and ranches all over the place, people using their horses for different things.
Yes.
And your main goal is to keep every horse healthy.
Yes.
Horses are susceptible to a lot of different ailments. One thing is ulcers and overall health. Is your product able to help, you know, cause problems like that?
We have many horses have come to us with serious ulcer problems. And within sometimes a week or less, sometimes a few weeks, they have no ulcer problems anymore. And that goes back to two things, the nervousness mm-hmm. and the raw starch.
Okay.
Raw starch in the gut makes a kind of a chronic production of acid. And if you get a backwash of acid out of the end of the stomach, back into the fore part of the stomach, you know what happens. It causes an irritation. That mm-hmm. makes them nervous. The more nervous they get, the more acid they produce. And the more acid they produce, the more nervous they get. And all of a sudden, we're feeding on this, and we get a full-blown product problem. So by going getting that gut health settled down, get the pH stabilized, all of a sudden, we start getting a calm horse, and the ulcers go away.
Okay. Well, I don't know anybody that wouldn't appreciate a calm horse. So.
Yeah.
We have one more phone call. Chase from New Mexico. Are you there, Chase?
Yeah.
All right, what's your question for Dr. Anderson?
I use Purina from Purina Mastojosis. I use Purina to AX to Purina. I use the alfalfa, all my horses, all my barrel horses, and to Mastojosis and to all the clinics.
Okay, so what was your question?
What kind of thing did he use? Anderson?
Oh, I think he's wanting to know the ingredients, which is a good question, which we really haven't touched
on. Well, the basic ingredients in Total Equine, and that's no secret, they're right on the tag, is it's made out of alfalfa, some corn, wheat middlings, rice bran, and soybean hulls.
Okay.
Those are the major ingredients. What makes Total Equine work is not the major ingredients. They are carriers for the micronutrient package that I use in it that does the all the head thing and the blood flow and all that is controlled by the micro package or the micronutrients, not the major nutrients. So I have people who get concerned about corn.
Yes.
I hear this a lot. They say, well, you have corn in there. That must be bad for a horse. Raw corn is bad for a horse. It's an enemy to a horse if fed improperly. When we extrude it, it is no longer a problem. And now it doesn't get in the hindgut. It doesn't ferment fast, and that's what the problem is with raw corn. So, and is it compatible with alfalfa? You said you were feeding alfalfa. Yes, it is. You can feed this with good grass hay. You can feed it with all alfalfa or a combination of the two. Some of the best horses I see out there are those that are fed alfalfa and total equine, good quality alfalfa and total equine, even though a lot of people believe that high protein causes an anxious horse. That is not true. An anxious horse is not caused by just high protein. It's caused by high protein in combination with raw starch.
Okay. It's also interesting because we hear so many different things. And, you know, it's hard to know what to believe.
Right.
Has your feed met all these promises?
Yes.
Okay.
Thankfully, it has. I get calls every once in a while. Somebody will call me and say, I've been on the Total Equine now for 2 months, and it's doing everything you say. Like, they shouldn't believe it.
Well, sometimes we don't get everything that we're promised, but it sounds like Total Equine's doing a good job. And we're going to hear from some people that have had success stories with using Total Equine. We want to remind you that we're still taking phone calls at 877-731-6733. If you have anything related to nutrition that you'd like to ask Dr. Anderson of Total Equine and Total Feeds, please give us a call. Stick around. We'll be back with more on RFD TV Live.